are watching Urban Television right here on Living, and my name is Anisha with a T. Now today we have a very special guest. She is a woman. You know my favorite day is Wednesday because it's Woman Crush Wednesday. We are crushing on Judith. Welcome to the show. I love your hair. I always love you. Always. I have never seen you looking bad. Never. You're always on point.
I think I love myself too much to actually
look bad.
Come out of the house looking bad.
So wait, when you wake up in the morning, your routine is like, do you know how to do this face bit, or you go to like Mona or someone?
Oh, when I wake up, it depends on how I'm feeling on that very morning. Sometimes I feel low, sometimes I feel hype. And makeup, I think I'm so blessed that all my friends do face bits. So yeah, sometimes there is a friend that says, oh, tomorrow I just want to come and work on your face. I want you to look amazing today. Or sometimes they just come out of the house without makeup.
Okay. Yes. So now, first of all, I've been stalking you on social media like I always do. You were in the States, now you're in Uganda. So when you came to the show, I'm like, she just moved today. Like, why did you come back?
I've been in the States. I'm back in the industry, modeling industry. And I happen to be signed to a modeling agency in Lagos that is promoting me. I'm back on the scene. I'm in New York. I'm back and forth, New York and Uganda, and then Paris, of course.
What?
Yes, so God has been amazing to me. I'm back on the scene, and I have a very good agency that is promoting me left, right, and center. Yes, so today I might be in Uganda, tomorrow I might be in Paris, the next day in New York.
You're enjoying your life. I'm living your best life. So how are you doing with the parenting? Are the kids like, because we have two beautiful daughters and...
Three,
yes. Yeah. Okay, I don't know. You know when you came on the scene, then you had these two angels. Yeah. Everyone was like, you had this name, na longo, it's together. Yeah. So how are you doing with the parenting?
Parenting
and
is always...
school.
Yeah, parenting is always going to be like the biggest achievement that I've achieved. So I make sure my kids have enough time with me. Of course, it will never be enough time because they're growing every second and you'd love to be there all the time. But when I'm not working, I'm with my family.
Did you travel with them? Are they with you?
Yeah, we traveled together actually. We've been in the US for 3 months together.
They're enrolled in school?
No, they're in school here. So that's why I had to come back here. I have an event, of course, but we're back here because school starts in, I think, next week.
So how are we going to do it? They'll be in school here without you when you're working?
I work and come back home. It's not like a move to the US, but I'm back and forth. When I'm not working, I'm going to be here. When I'm working, I'll just travel. But my mother is here, my two sisters.
Oh, thank God. Thank God for mothers.
And you know, my mother, actually, if my mother did a good job raising me, so I think she'd do better with her grandkids.
Yeah.
So I have my mother, I have my two sisters that are always available because they're not married. One is not married, so... she will help me.
Girl, you're doing it. And we all know after that bad incident, it's like, you know, it's funny, God, like, it's like that happened, and then people are, they're nanga, you hate us. However much you hate, and someone has decided that God has looked at her and she's like, she's going to shine, whether
God
you please or
exactly.
Exactly. Yeah. How does that make you feel? Because, I mean, after that incident happened, it's like, boom. She's in the stage. She signed up. She's booming. And then, you know what happened? Eh?
Yeah.
You chick, you're too bad. Week after week, day after day, she's posing here, strutting here, doing this, that. It's like, that didn't even stop you. It just kept motivating you.
Everything that happens in my life, I look at it as a blessing in disguise.
Mm.
So when something bad happens to me, I make sure I overlook it. I go in my room, pray about it, and the next day I'm like, you know what? What doesn't kill you makes you stronger, and I'm here to stay. I'm not going to go to exile because something bad has happened to me. The only thing I have to do is face my problems and find a way to actually recover from it and keep going forward. If I'm broken, then the people that hate me are going to be like, yes, we conquered because she's out of place, she's no longer on social media, she's sad. So I don't want anybody to see me sad, so I just pray about everything and come back better and stronger.
Wow, that's good for you. Yeah. Now, first of all, let us know, how did you get this sign up? Was it like you're there sitting, or did you actually sign up for for like, you like, you know what? It's about the time I get back into the modeling industry. Did you work hard or it just came? You're like,
I always work hard for everything that I want. I love my career as a model, but I posed as a mother to raise my kids. And these people had been following me on social media, and one day they got in touch with me. They're like, are you signed to any modeling agency? I was like, not really. I actually posed it, I'm raising my kids, and they were like, no, you have everything. You still have it all, you're a mother, you're a beautiful, gorgeous young woman. I'm like, yes, young. And they're like, yes, you still have time to do this. You can do, age is just a number. If you love something, you go for it. And they were like, yeah, I would love to sign you up. And it actually happened when I was in Lagos, so.
So you're going for like a treat or a holiday, and then, you know,
no,
bada boom, bada bang.
I'd actually gone for MTV Awards, yes.
Oh, so that's how it happened.
Yeah.
So I think social media has played a big role in your career.
Oh,
being out
yes.
there.
Social media is playing the biggest role in everyone's career. Mm. Everyone that is out there trying to push something, everybody that has something going on in their lives, everybody's on social media.
That is very true. You need, yeah. You're
selling
the product,
media.
You need social media.
Yeah.
You need it to help you with
also
everything.
Meeting new friends.
Yes.
Making new
you're
friends.
You're a very friendly person. But there's an outcome as a cause. Because, yeah, let me tell you, there's a time I met you even before I was in this scene, and we had gone for the Kampala Festival, and I had a stain, and you helped me, and I don't even think
Aww.
You remember. But, like, you didn't even know me, but you helped me.
Yeah.
But doesn't that also... So people take advantage of the fact that you're just a good person. Then people are just naturally good-hearted.
Yeah.
Don't people take advantage of that?
Of course, people that you meet in your life, they're good people, and some are bad people, and some of them actually take advantage of you being nice to them. But at the end of the day, you cannot change who you are, but you can just be good at what at you. You know, some people will come in your life, and just because you're too nice to them, they take advantage
of
that. Some will actually appreciate you and just love you.
That's beautiful.
So people, yeah.
So
do take
how
advantage.
Do you spot them out? Because you know, being like I keep telling people, being in the spotlight is hard because you don't know who is genuine. Some people can put up an act. You know, eh? People were like, but this chick, she's all nicey-nicey. And then 3 years down the lane, you realize this person actually didn't like me. How do you spot out the genuine ones? Do you
God does an amazing job at spotting out those people. Because you're nice to people, but at the end of the day, you're not going to open their hearts to know who's real, who's bad.
Yes.
But God always chooses those good people around you, and he'll always make sure they stay in your life. And the bad ones, before you know it, they go deep
gone.
Down in a hole, or sometimes they get flushed in the toilet.
So let's talk about your family. We already talked about how your mom's doing your mom and your sisters are helping you out, and I think that's been a strong background. Have they supported you from the very beginning?
Yes.
You know, have they always been behind you? Or some people I interview have been like, my mom was like, wow, I don't like the line of job you're doing. You need to change your career. You need to be about a banker. Were they behind you from the very start?
Yes, my family's always been supportive. I've been blessed with very understanding people around me. And my sisters, my mom, my uncles, my aunties, my husband, everybody's always been supportive, because at the end of the day, it's what you want, not what they want. And if people can actually understand this, we would all be living a very happy life, because if you don't understand me, then you're going to always force me to things that you want me to do. So it's not about what my parents want or what my family want me to do. It's about what I want to do, and it's them to support me so I can be successful at what I'm doing.
Wow.
So my family's always been supportive, because they know what she wants, she has to get. That's how I was raised. And
You know, for a long time, people will be like, you know, when you gave it a break, and then you're raising your kids, why is Judith Hart still in people's faces? What is she doing, you know? You know, like, one time people were like, she's like a Kardashian. Kardashians don't have a talent. I'm like, well, I mean, if you go check the bank account, probably bigger than yours. People love to talk. Now you're showing them exactly what you're doing.
Human beings will always talk. You see, they even talk about the day. But it's always good when people talk about you and you're not doing anything. But I think I'm doing so much. That's why I'm
doing a lot. I'm surprised how you're juggling, because even just moving from one country to another, traveling is the hardest thing. I'm like, it's fun when you're there, but the transit.
By the time I always tell my husband, oh my God, I don't think I remember my name by the time you get here. But good enough, we travel business class. We're always comfortable. And yes, my husband has always made sure we're comfortable when we're traveling. So by the time we get here, it's just like, I woke up
like this. Yes. Anyway, you have an event coming up, but unfortunately we have to wrap up. We'll be talking about an event, and on that event, you have a female DJ.
Yes, we have female DJ.
That is exciting for Woman Crush Wednesday. Who better to have?
Women.
Yes. Now, unfortunately, we have to take a quick break. When we come back, we'll be having Judith Hard and Kathy on the show. We'll be right back.